you wouldn't know. You have to know my past and where I came from to understand what's going on with my mom and the kidnapping of my family and the destruction of what happened. And so I guess here we go. This will probably take a minute. I was born in Ohio. My mom was born in Ohio. Her dad was murdered by a police officer when she was very young. So it left her without a father. My family has never really been rich or had anything, a lot of anything. So it's, you know, a little bit different. She's going to call right back. That's my mom. She's able to call me. But anyway, back to what I was saying. We were both born in Ohio. I know when I was a baby, my mom and my grandma stole me from each other. When I was two, my mom met a man and his son, and we traveled around the United States. During that time of traveling around the United States, I was... is it still on? I was trafficked out of different hotels. I remember being where the Grand Canyon was. I remember being in Vegas. I remember being in California. And every night, my mom would have to leave and go to work. And when that's when my part would start. I was able to, and this is from the age of two until I was seven, around the time I was seven. I was able to get high or get drunk. She ain't gonna get it. But I was able to get high or get drunk. And that way I wouldn't feel what was happening to me. I was beaten till I was deaf. I have scars behind my ears. My grandma got me after my mom finally left the guy that was trafficking us and taking us around the United States. And when she did, we ended up in Mississippi because the people at the strip club at the Horseshoe Lounge and the people that my mom was involved with, this is how she got linked up with the Dixie Mafia that I know. They had clubs and they offered to help my mom to get away from the situation. I was still very young. I slept in the strip club at the Horseshoe Lounge in Biloxi, Mississippi on Veterans Boulevard, which is now completely closed down, thank God. My mom worked for the mayor's family. That is our mayor now, Andrew Fofo Gillich. And I don't care what anybody wants to say, but I know that my mom's past has a lot to do with the kidnapping of my family today. I don't care what people want to try to discredit, but you let my past, you can run my name. I'll tell you, I used to sell their drugs for them. I used to be one of their girls. I used to answer the phone for these people, for the man that bought his freedom. Kirksey Nix helped and had his part in a murder of a judge and wife. And with that said, you know, he is free today. And he's only free because the guy that is our mayor, Andrew Fofo Gillich, when he became in power, I don't know exactly how it happened, but they got this man transferred for the first time in over 25 years, almost 30 years. And with him being transferred, he was able to be released for his crimes of killing a judge and wife. Do y'all understand that? These people are bad. The GAL that never knew me, her name is Jenny Tyler Baker. She wrote the GAL report before she ever even met me. And that is a proven fact. I don't post everything online, but I post a lot. There's just some things that I can't because that is my evidence against them. It was 13 days after she became the DA, after they started kidnapping my grandson. My mama's role when she worked for the family back at the time they did this, and you can look it up, Mississippi Mud and the Dixie Mafia documentary, and you will see the Lonely Heart scam, but it was not just the Lonely Heart scam. It was also behind gambling rights on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. and the gambling rights. People need to research, before the casinos were on the Gulf Coast, who owns the gambling rights for Mississippi? Who owned the gambling rights back then? I didn't know people owned the gambling rights. I'm going to let that for you to go look, because that holds the key to what's really going on behind the corruption in Mississippi, and something needs to be done about it. The lady that kidnapped my grandson, Benson, she drew up her own adoption papers before my grandson was even born, and it states in her own adoption paper that she tried to put insurance on a minor child before he was ever even born. The fake GAO and the fake GAO report, she just a sudden becomes the DA 13 days after the beginning of the kidnapping of my grandson. And by who? The Gillich family. And I want to point something out for people that actually do pay attention and that will maybe try to help me. The Gillich family likes to do something with their name. They like to drop an L. It's spelled G-I-L-L-I-C-H, but depends if it's corrupt or not corrupt, if they have two L's or one L. But it's linked to the same people. I found this when I went and did fact checks on these people and back checks and everything I could find to figure out who these people were and who their families are. You know, and when you go search my background, yeah, I have a felony on my record, but it's been over 20 years ago. Almost 20 years ago. This is when I was running their drugs. I was running specifically ecstasy for these people. And come to find out, the guy, Greg, is on our mayor's, Andrew Fofo Gillich, Facebook. And he helped set up one of the other boys, Little Jimmy Manning, got set up by Greg. And Greg is friends with the Gillich family. They have been running drugs on the Mississippi Gulf Coast for so long. Drugs and girls is their thing. Now, let's get back to who their family tree is of the people that my mom worked for. You have Mike Gillich Jr. That's the one that went to jail for the murders. You have little Mike. He's the one that keeps going to jail and getting off with $100 fines for beating up people and so have you, because who? His family is what? The mayor. He gets off. His sister is Tina Rose Gillich. She has since moved to California. Now that leaves one person that I cannot find, and that is their brother, Joey. Now, my opinion, I think Joey is somebody who is not, because Joey, back then, when I was a kid, and they were doing this stuff out of the strip clubs with me and my mom, he was a transgender. Very ugly transgender. But that's just what they gotta do, that's what they do, whatever. Him, I cannot find his information of who he is. Tina Gillich was my mother's attorney. My mom watched her make fake IDs for people not of this country. My mom watched this right after Katrina. She watched this before Katrina. I was even arrested at one point in time and told that I had like 6 or 7 different Mexican names under my social security number, and I needed to prove who I was. And like I told the officer, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. But coming to think about what my mom told me and about what she saw through Tina Gillich, I understand, because that was my mom's lawyer, and she took everything from my mom. My mom had boats. She had 2 Bayliners, a 16-foot and 18-foot. She had cars. She had Jeeps. She had a nice house. I had everything when she worked for them. But when they murdered the lady and her husband, the judge, the Sherrys in Mississippi, I lost everything. My mom lost everything. They started treating her for being crazy. They started doing electric shock therapy on my mom without anybody in the family even knowing about it. Only the people that were over her, which are the people of corruption that has her locked up now. And that's what people don't understand. And, you know, I'm not the best person in the world, but I'm not a bad person by far. I mean, I did wrong things, but I learned from my mistakes. That was years and years and years ago. That's not today. That wasn't yesterday. It wasn't last year. It wasn't 3 years ago or 4 years ago. This was years ago. When I got in my little bit of trouble, I walked away from these people. I woke up and realized what was really going on, from the gangs to the politics to our politicians, our lawyers. I mean, people really need to think, where do the drugs really come from that's on our streets? Do you really think these kids are just making it up out of thin air? No. They come from the lawyers, the politicians, the people in power that are able to supply it out in our community. Even right after Katrina, a sheriff was arrested, and like I think 7 other people were arrested. I met the lady and spoke with her briefly. The sheriff's house that she bought was so meth-filled that she was so sick it ate her intestines. It made her sick. And this came from the sheriff. You understand, the sheriff had this. He was manufacturing methamphetamine to pass out in the community to arrest these kids for selling it for him. Why, they just sit back and collect the money. This is how it's been in Mississippi for years. Years and years. I've watched Bennett. I know. And when I walked away, they went after my son. They went after my mom. And when I stood up for my grandson, because they straight kidnapped my grandson. That's when they went after my mom and took her. She has an owner. We don't know who her owner is. The owner that we have his phone number, the phone number has been disconnected. The address has been moved out of. You can follow me on my YouTube and find it. I mean, I record everything, my phone calls. My mom has been abused. The facility will not have a conversation with us. They said that we're not her owner, so it's none of our business about my mom's care. Right now, my mom needs to go to a hospital, and they refuse. They won't take my mom to a hospital. And she has blisters on her legs. She's had them for over 2 weeks. She says her urine smells so bad of ammonia, and she's starting to pee on herself. That means she has a bladder infection, and these people will not take her to a doctor. They don't care about my mom, they don't care about me, and they don't care about my grandson. These are bad people. And the, you know, I'm doing something different that my community have never seen. To the point I don't care anymore. They've shot at me in my home. They came through my attic. They ran out my business. They had some man follow me for a week, which I had, like I said, I got everything recorded. For a week through my business, and he pulled a gun on me and lost his balls to shoot me underneath the camera. He saw the camera and he put the gun back in his car. I have never in my life, when I worked for them selling their drugs and helping them sell their girls and, you know, doing what they wanted me to do, everything was fine. I was never robbed. I was never shot at. Never had my house broken into. Never was messed with. But when I walked away and I went against them, I've had all this happen to me in the last 3 years. I mean, it's been a hell of a ride. And all I want is my mom. My mom is a human being. My mom has suffered and paid her dues for being with these people. She's lost her mind to the point where she can't take properly care of herself on her own. No, she does need help. But who's going to take care of my mom better than me? You know, these facilities ain't doing it. They won't even take her to a doctor for a bladder or kidney infection or nothing. They'd rather sit there and watch her die with blisters popping on her legs, and her legs are in pain. They threatened her that if she ever called the police on them again, she'll never be able to use the phone. They can't do that. This is illegal. She's a human being. But it doesn't matter what paper I file in any of these courts or my kids. They get court stamped in front of us, and it gets pushed through a file, and we get laughed at. And the more that we go into court and try to file something, the more harassment we get from the police, other attorneys, and their friends. It's called government gang stalking, if you didn't know. And they're pretty damn good at it. They're really damn good at it. When I protest for my mother on February 14th of 2018, I walked out of the court after filing a habeas corpus because there's no crimes committed against me or my mom for my mom to be held against her will with taxpayers' dollars paying to push her from facility to facility. If you also look down on my wall, you'll see a video with an anonymous mask. And it's about the recorded conference call. That recorded conference call that is on my YouTube, my mom was stable to come home. She was fine. The DOJ has found enough evidence that Mississippi has been in non-compliance for 20 years of demeaning patients with mental illness. This is a bigger issue than just my family, because that lawsuit affects 5,000 people have been affected. She's just one person of that 5,000. This is 2019. They filed that in August 11th of 2016. Nothing to this day has been done. I rewrote that lawsuit because I felt their Medicaid fraud. J.D. Lee, she is the court attorney for the patients with mental illness on the Gulf Coast. She has been there as long as I know. I mean, as long as I know. She gets paid to destroy families, hold people against their will. If it wasn't for her and her lies, we wouldn't have the DOJ's lawsuit. We wouldn't have 5,000 people locked up. I'm not saying she's responsible for the whole 5,000, but I guarantee you she's responsible for a lot. Because when my mom is put into a state facility, when a judge commits her, and normally when she's committed, the facility, the Gulf Coast Mental Health on the coast, they're like the doctors, no, they don't have doctors there no more. They have what's called like nurse practitioners. They'll tweak her medicine. They'll change ER to DR or vice versa, or lower a milligram or something, just enough to get my mom happy. For me to have to call and say, hey, my mom's not acting right, her medicine ain't right, she'll get picked up. They'll take her to the court. She'll get, after she gets committed, so they can go put her in the state facility. Once she's committed, your tax dollars pays each state facility per head, per person. Medicaid doesn't pay unless they're on long term. Gulf Coast Mental Health is not affiliated in any way, and I have this recorded and documented, with any state facility. When my mother, the day that she is committed, Gulf Coast Mental Health starts stealing $506 plus a day. My mother is one person, and they can steal $90,000. $90,000 for one person for a 3-week stay. That is a lot of money. Now you times that by 5,000 and do that about 2 to 3 times a year. How much money are they stealing from Medicaid and from people? How much tax dollars are being spent in Mississippi to hold people like my mom against their will? It's a bigger picture than just my mother. And, you know, I'm trying to get people to come out and stand with. I'm not going out there to scream and yell at these people. Although today I did have something to say to J.D. Lee. And I'm going to be there in the morning. Hopefully I'm going to be able to go to sleep tonight and get up early. Because I want to know, how much did she get paid over all these years that I've been dealing with court and my mom? She's been my mother's attorney. How many years has she been doing this and helping these people commit fraud and stealing people's stuff? When they picked up my mom, they knew that I had just bought her a camper for her birthday. That was the first thing they asked for. Where is her property? You got to turn it over to us right now. They said they took my mom because I didn't do an audit. If you read a conservatorship, guardianship papers for the state of Mississippi, I can even post mine, I don't care. There's nowhere in these papers that it says that the state of Mississippi owns my mom and she's not allowed to leave the state, and I have to go to the courthouse and tell them anything that she owns and been bought. The only person I have to file an audit with is SSI Disability. I was told this by the United States Justice Department in D.C. right after Trump came into office and they did the government shutdown, and that guy disappeared and I haven't been able to talk to him since. But he straight up told me that is illegal, of the reason why they're saying they took my mom. And if it's something that simple, why have they held her for over a year and a half against her will, passed her from facility to facility? Now, mind me, December 8th, recorded conference call. My mother's medication was stable, and I have that recorded by the doctor. Why did they push her through, now I want to say 10 different facilities in a year and a half, and changed her medicine almost at every single one of them, so the doctors can line their pockets with fraudulent state-funded money? Your taxpayer dollars pays for this. Why do they do that? Please explain that to me. My mom is one person they done this to. And there is 5,000 in the DOJ's lawsuit. How many people hasn't spoke up? How many people more is there? When they take these people and they're putting them in these homes and they act like they're just nobody anymore, are these people's social security numbers and things being used so they can gain money and access? Is that why my mom's not getting anything? My mom, I have to buy her clothes, bathroom products. It's just like she's in jail. They don't provide her nothing. They take money, made her lose her home, and they provide her with absolutely nothing. All I know is I had a call of my mom crying. And yes, on that call I said I would whoop that lady's ass. I'd pull my mama, I would. But hearing her cry in the background, you would want to go through that phone too if it was your mom. Or if it was your child. You know, what these people did to my mom with the electric shock therapy behind murdering of a judge and their wife to hide their crimes, that's kind of what they did to my mom. They fried her brain to the point that she's an adult, she knows how to make adult decisions, but there's some things she just can't do for herself anymore, and she hasn't been able to do for a long time. And it's all been covered up behind corruption. And what people need to realize, the people that my mom worked for back then, it's their children, their grandchildren, that are our lawyers, our doctors, and so forth. It's their family. Do you honestly think that they walked away from the corruption from 30 years ago and have more than the families had back then? If they're not still in the corruption, because they sure in the hell ain't helping nobody in the community. They're only helping their pocketbooks. I have threats on my phone about the drug running from one of Andrew Fofo Gillich's, which is our mayor in Biloxi's friend. He kept posting on one of my Facebooks that got closed down. I can't use it no more. I kept posting all kinds of obscene stuff because I posted something about the original Mike Gillich that paid years ago about him being a drug lord and running girls and all that. And well, his dad went to jail for his involvement, or his son went to jail for his involvement. And now look who our mayor is. And he kept posting stuff. In fact, he posted his number in there and said, call him. That's also on my wall. I called him. I was mad. Because he's trying to tell me who trafficked me and my mom. I didn't know who put drugs in my hand. I didn't know who had me out there working for them, selling my booty because I thought that was normal because I was trafficked as a child. And I thought that was normal. And it's not normal. It's very messed up to groom a child to think that it's normal to way to make a bunch of money. When I grew up and walked away from these people because I wanted my freedom, they destroyed my life. And now, I don't care anymore. They, like I said, they done shot at me, ran me out my business. My vehicle's gone. I can't function without my mom and knowing that she is hurt and wants to be with family. I can't function knowing that my son's life has been totally destroyed. He lost his marriage. He lost his kids. He lost everything behind lies and the people and politics in my town, and it's so embedded in our police department, sir. And all he can say is, I'm here for my paycheck. That's really sad. He's there for his paycheck and nothing else because he wants to keep his job. My mom's ex-boyfriend, he helped with the investigation of the Sherry murders. His name was Steve Patterson. He was just a plain Jane cop at that time. He later became Biloxi Chief of Police. And then he stole my mom's checks and Toby came over them. And I told him, I said, motherfucker, don't contact my mom no more because you're not going to steal from her. And if you go back and watch, it's going to be a long video. It's one of my visits with my mom. It's on my Facebook channel. I have Angela Ward and Angel Pond. It has a Statue of Liberty. It has a money over the eyes and a gag of a American flag in the mouth. When you find that, you will, I mean, just go down and look at our visits. It's a long thing. She'll tell you, he's not her owner no more. Why in the heck, before we have owners over her, would she say that a police officer is not her owner no more? Do you understand the mind games that they played on my family? Please, if you don't, I mean, conspiracy is a crime. It's when more than two people get together to purposely cause you harm and violate your rights. It's not something that, oh, it's something somebody made up or they just think it's crazy and it's something in a la-la land and it's not real. You're programmed to think that because that's how these people get away with their crimes. Wow, this thing just cut off. I'm glad that one stayed on. But that's how they get away with their crimes. And I got another phone here, but it just went off. They don't want me to share my story. Every time I go to share my story and the real story, it gets cut out. And it's really sad. You know, police officer sells guns, what, 2017? To a bunch of gang members, and then they turn around and have to do a bunch of gun sweep and take the guns off the road, but you know what he gets? No jail time. What does he get? Drugs for them and push their drugs and move their drugs and did everything they asked to do. They got their lives taken away. And they don't even understand who the hell they were even working for because they're kids and don't know. It took me a long time to grow up, but I did. And I'm still here. And I want to fight against this corruption. I just want my family home. And I wish more people in Mississippi will say enough is enough. And let's bring justice back to Mississippi and release these people that are being held against their will. Stop stealing children and telling them to go to freaking meetings to say that they're crazy and label them with something so they can enter into the court system and, you know, be labeled. So they don't have a reason to give their children back because now they have been labeled. But really, they're just a disorder from their children from being snatched or their family member. It's not that they're crazy. They're not. Much love.